Meat, 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 meat. A roiling sea of meat.
And now, an interview with a hot girl who does stuff on the internet.
This is a hot chick that does stuff online.
Eric Martin.
Did this.
It's radio by the people and for the people. Book reviews of experimental Estonian metafiction, deep cuts from Tuvian throat singing albums, and car talk. You've all heard of public radio, but have you ever seen it?
We just watched a clip of This American Wife. Why don't you give the audience a little bit of an idea of what we just saw?
Sure. So what you saw was This American Wife, the web series. It is a gentle parody of public radio, and it's based on our podcast of the same name, This American Wife, which might sound like another show that you've heard of on public radio.
So how did This American Wife, the podcast, get started?
Mm-hmm. Well, it started off with my friend and writing partner, Ned Hepburn. We were working on a few different things because we thought we'd pitch some stuff around town and then realize, let's just do something, and something's eventually going to stick. And so we started, he came up with the name This American Wife, and I thought, there's something we can do with this. I had listened to a lot of public radio, so I knew that format, and I thought, let's just make it a parody of all these public radio shows. I've been hearing millions of people listen to these shows, but almost nobody's doing anything about it. Nobody's making fun of it. We can do that. Turns out there is a huge market for fake public radio, as we've come to discover.
Who knew? How did you get started in that? I mean, obviously you have a total radio voice.
Oh, thank you.
I'm sure people have told you that before. But yeah, how did you get your start?
It actually started when I was about 3 years old.
Oh.
And my aunt used to, we would come over, like stay at my grandma's, and my brother and I would just have my aunt would have this tape recorder, and we would just record our voices into it and do a little funny sketch, and it was obviously like we were just little kids, but I loved it, and you couldn't pull me away from this thing. So ever since I was a little kid, I had always been just wanting to talk and use my voice.
So do you still have the recordings from when you were a child?
I do. I haven't listened to them in 30-some years.
How come that's not on your podcast?
There probably needs. Thank you. If you don't mind, I just may use that for a segment.
I absolutely think you should. You know, I mean, why not? Pull like that little... I mean, your voice has probably changed quite a bit, I would imagine. Maybe mm-hmm. not, though. Maybe this is the same voice you had when you were three.
That's not quite true, but I did sound like this, like when my voice changed at like age 11, and I've sounded like this ever since then.
So when you were 11,
yeah.
You had this deep voice as a kid.
Yeah.
Were the friend, like, did you just narrate things on the playground?
I always...
A girl who goes down the slide.
I always played old men, because I did plays,
okay.
And so I would always be playing old men, people with gravitas, just because I could.
So then the web series, how did that get started then from the podcast? Because it's unusual to sort of have a podcast then lead into web series. I'm not even sure. I think you guys might be the only one.
I think we are the only one, and hopefully we will be the first of many. Hopefully we're starting the trend, setting the scene. Podcast into web series into new media juggernauts. We're starting it here today. So we had been doing the show for a couple of years, and we had been getting some great guests and collaborating with folks like Super Ego and Thrilling Adventure Hour. They have some great podcasts that are also live shows. And we started thinking about what would make sense for our show. And of course, the This American Life for a couple of years did a very successful TV series on Showtime, but they stopped doing it because they wanted to focus on just their radio show. So, but there were a lot of people that loved that show. And it's been off the air for a couple of years, but people still remember it very fondly. That image of, you know, Ira Glass at the desk outside is such an iconic thing.
Right.
We thought, let's just make fun of that. Like, people want to see more of that. Let's do it with jokes.
Do you have any books coming out that we can listen to and you can read to us at home?
Yeah, if you're not irritated by my voice yet, and if you want to be soothed by its dulcet tones as you find out about new and exciting things, hey, books, check them out. There are two exciting ones that are coming out that I'm really into. One is Detroit, An American Autopsy by Pulitzer Prize winner Charlie LaDuff.
Wow.
It's an amazing story of sort of the decline of Detroit. You know, it started out pretty good, not doing so good these days, but it's a really raw and personal story while also a bigger picture thing. It's an awesome book. And the one that I'm reading right now is called, and this will be an Audible featured book in the next couple of weeks, it's called Weird Life. And it's the science of creatures that are very, very different from the ones we know.
So like mud puppies?
It's absolutely. Mud puppies is chapter one.
Is it really?
No, actually, I have no idea what mud puppies are.
They are the most disgusting, cute, sort of weird salamander things with, like, these tentacles, and then they, like, crawl out of the ground. They, like, half live in the mud and the water, and then they're like, land, water thing, creature things.
Even weirder.
What is the weirdest creature that you've read about that you would want as a pet?
Probably Pikachu. Yeah, if anybody has any ideas for cute, cuddly, weird creatures, hit me up on Twitter.
Dust bunnies. Are you ready to play Hot Meat of the Week?
Hot Meat of
the
Week.
I'm as ready as I'll ever be.
Jay Leno.
Sweet.
Jimmy Fallon.
Corpulent.
North Korea.
Gotham style.
Final Four.
No.
Pipeline Week.
Bathing.
First two-headed bull shark.
Is a friend of mine.
That was the Hot Meat of the Week.
Hot Meat of the Week.
Hot Meat of the Week.
Guys, thank you so much for tuning into the Meaty Grind. I'm your host, Sarah Fletcher. This is
Eric Martin.
Please make sure to check out our new content on Tuesdays, which is going to be This American Wife, who is created by this guy right here. And this is
Eric Martin.
And remember what Mama says.
Put your brother down.